Amendment at the desk.
The clerk will report the amendment.
Amendment number two. Amendment to the committee print of H.R. 4230.
I ask unanimous consent to dispense with the reading and without objection, so ordered. I recognize the gentleman for 5 minutes to explain his amendment.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for holding this markup, Chairwoman Johnson. My amendment is simple. Fossil fuels are essential to the United States' manufacturing and industrial competitiveness. Over the past two decades, Asia has accounted for 90% of all coal-fired capacity built worldwide, and the average plant is just 12 years old. They are growing, and they are using fossil fuels to do it. And you can be certain that they will not wait for us based on the promise of clean energy in the future. I'm supportive of basic research, and I think that some of our fundamental science will lead to breakthroughs that can help reduce carbon emissions across the board in the industrial sector. The intent of this bill is to focus on those areas and produce commercial technologies. But as it stands right now, we cannot abandon our tried and true infrastructure that is dependent upon fossil fuels. Over 80% of the United States' energy consumption comes from natural gas, oil, and coal, the three sources that we commonly refer to as fossil fuels. Plus, I would remind you all that America has reduced our emissions by 5% since the early 2000s. There is an estimated 1.7 trillion barrels of known oil reserves left on Earth. The U.S. is projected to double our export capacity of liquefied natural gas by the end of 2020. Leaving these two resources untapped is the equivalent of burying money underground and then forgetting the location. Factories, schools, and hospitals are dependent upon reliable power, and turning the switch off would be disastrous. Steel producers, cement kilns, recycling facilities have no other option than fossil fuels at the moment. As I look to my right and my left, there is not a single member here who wouldn't have their district affected if we walked away from fossil energy. With this in mind, there is a middle ground to be found. Carbon capture, materials research, and high-performance computing are all areas where basic research can yield promising results in emissions reduction. My point, and the point of this amendment, is this. Don't make fossil fuels the enemy. Emissions are the common enemy, and technology can help mitigate those even in the fossil fuel industry, as we have seen in field hearing down in Texas just recently. My amendment would send the message that our industries and our manufacturers have nothing to worry about. We're not going to force you to abandon your lifeline of fossil energy. We're here to help, and we're on your side in the fight to reduce carbon emissions. The great state of Texas and many other energy-producing states' economies depend on having open markets free of repressive regulations to continue our amazing prosperity and job creation of late. I emphasize the importance of this amendment. However, Madam Chair, I will at this time withdraw it and hope that in the future that we keep all of these ideals in mind. I yield back.
Thank you very much. Any other requests?